Hey, welcome back to another video. Transom from Russia, which is a producer, and I link his channel, his YouTube channel in the description below, made me aware of a problem or a checkbox, a parameter inside the grid that is maybe worth highlighting. And the manual says various grid modules have a parameter called effect voice lifetime. When this parameter is enabled, the module is included in the calculation for whether each voice is still sounding and should be kept alive. Modules that have this parameter include AR, AD, ADSR, gate in, audio out. And yeah, let's look at that in the grid. I have here a simple setup. I have a swarm oscillator, an ADSR, and a low pass filter, and we're going straight to the mixer and the audio out here. And you have here this effect voice lifetime parameter or checkbox, and I turn it off so I can show you what the problem is. So now we are in the grid and we have 8 voices activated, so we are in polyphony mode. So, and now I press different keys on my keyboard here. And it sounds pretty okay, because the ADSR, when we watch the point or the dot pass the envelope here and it comes to the release phase and we are at the end, the voice is cut off and it sounds perfectly fine. But when we introduce delays, and I have here a mod delay and an all pass filter which gives some sort of reverb effect, then we have a problem. Let's listen to that. And it sounds like the voice is cut off because the grid decides that the voice should be cut off, because the ADSR says this voice is over or is finished, and the voice is cut off basically. And when we go to the audio out here and activate this effect voice lifetime parameter, then we have a threshold and a timeout value. And now the grid calculates or see that some of the voices are still have audio output, and the grid keeps these voices alive. And this sounds like this. So now you can see the ADSR is basically finished and the dot is at the end of the release phase, but the voice is still kept alive. And you hear the reverb sound. And this is maybe much more heavier on the CPU, but you still want to have hear this reverb and the delay effects after the ADSR is over. So this is a checkbox of the audio output module, where you can activate it and use threshold and timeout to basically calculate if the sound or voice should be kept alive. But you also can use it here on the RDSR. There's also this checkbox, and the other one is the gate in. This should be this one here. Yeah. So there's also an effect voice lifetime value, and you can use it on the audio out. But maybe when you have a more complex patch and you don't care so much about a different path that should be kept alive, then you can throw it into different modules inside your patch and decide that way what should be kept alive and what should be cut off. And I think that's a very important parameter to highlight, because at default, or by default, this parameter is disabled. And maybe you fiddle around in the grid and decide to make some reverbs, and then you have this problem and see, wow, what's happening with my voices. So keep that in mind, use this parameter. Thanks to Transom for pointing me out that it's maybe worth to make a tutorial or show this to a greater audience. And yeah, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.